Well, the financial pain being felt by Sydney families was hijacked today by some clever politics.
A gaffe by Tony Abbott helped the Gillard government divert attention from its attack on the baby bonus and back to the opposition leader's alleged sexism. National Affairs editor Paul Bongiorno joins us now from Canberra. Paul, explain to us how they managed to do that.
Well, Bill, in politics, words are bullets. Tony Abbott chose his words poorly today and they backfired. That's when he said that the government didn't understand families. Now, in a cabinet of 21, only two ministers are childless. That's Bob Carr and Julia Gillard. The government seized on these remarks as further evidence of Mr Abbott's prejudice against our female Prime Minister. Both leaders addressed farmers today, but earlier Mr Abbott seemed to drive a tractor over Ms Gillard.
I think if the government was a bit more experienced in this area, they wouldn't come out with glib lines like that.
He was replying to the Treasurer's excuse for cutting the baby bonus. Additional babies don't cost as much. The government wasn't buying it.
If he's talking about the Treasurer, well, he's got several children. I've got several children, so what's he really on about?
Could it be the childless Prime Minister?
Mr Abbott can explain what he meant by that line.
Mr Abbott went on radio to mop up.
Were you in any way referring to the Prime Minister's lack of children?
Of course not.
Joe Hockey says the debate is getting absurd.
If we're at the point now where we can't refer to the government and families in the same breath,
The Guardian's website, one of the most widely read internationally, reported the row. Mr Abbott decided to cut his losses.
If she wants to take offence, I'm sorry about that.
The opposition at this stage isn't promising to vote against the $500 million savings changes to the baby bonus would make, but it is promising to scrap the $2 billion kids' school bonus if it wins government.
It's just handing out money to people whether they like it or not.
For someone with two teenage children, it's worth something like $1,600 a year when they're at high school.
The Treasurer accuses the opposition of not getting it. Well, Julia Gillard, despite all the sound and fury, is fairly confident the opposition will allow her budget changes through the parliament. She says they have formed trenchant criticism only to allow bills through. Alka-Pops comes to mind. And today, Tony Abbott was still keeping his options open. He says he's waiting to see the shape of the legislation.
Paul Bongiorno in Canberra, thank you.